Hello my friends, welcome back to Keto and the Chaos. On this channel, I like to share all my tips and tricks on how I lost 200 pounds on keto and how you can be successful on your own keto weight loss journey. So if that's what you're looking for, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and stick around for more videos to inspire you on your journey like this one. My name is Tammy. It's Sunday, October 24th, 2019, and it's weigh-in day! Happy Sunday, everyone. Welcome back. It's Halloween Sunday. We are in full Halloween prep mode over here at my house. I don't know about you guys, but if you have kids, Halloween can be a big, big deal around your house. We always have a Halloween theme for costumes for our family, and so we've been working on that. We were supposed to do pictures today, but it's snowing out. So I don't know if I'm going to force them to go out and do pictures today or not. We will see, but anyway, we are getting ready to go to our family Halloween party right now. Dave is downstairs making delicious keto chili for us to take, and we are in full prep mode for getting ready to go spend some time with family. So I'm not going to spend too much time on our update today because I need to go and help him get ready. This week went pretty well. Compared to last week, I did a lot better. If you guys came and hung out with me on Tuesday, I talked about what my goals were going to be for getting back on track after having that scary situation and fun situation and off the grid situation last week where I ate too many calories. This week, basically, all I did was go back to my regular fat loss macros. So I didn't go on any crazy fasting or like do anything ridiculous, crazy amount of cutting calories. I just went back to my normal macros of 120 protein, 78 fat, and 21 net carbs. And that's what I stuck to for the first part of the week. After a few days, a lot of the water weight washed off, and I decided I was going to go back to my macros for maintenance, just like I had planned to for the rest of the year. So, that being said, let's see what the scale said today, and we will talk about that, and I'll let you know if I'm going to change anything for the upcoming week. So as you can see, I weighed in today at 180.6, which is a 6 pound loss for the week. Now we all know that that was probably not any fat loss, that it was mostly water weight coming back off of this week. I am definitely still retaining water. And in fact, just a couple of days ago, I actually was 178.2. So I'm actually up from what I was just a couple of days ago. So I'm guessing this is just my normal water retention that I usually have at this time in my lady cycle. I have no idea. I don't know what is up with my body half the time, but you know what? It is what it is. Just like always, I'm going to be happy that I saw the 170s this week. Hopefully I will see the 170s again very soon because the 170s is where I'd like to be throughout the holiday season. If for some reason this week I just stay at 180 and I don't quite go down to 170, I might change something, but for right now, my plan is to just do my regular maintenance macros for this week. So if you saw my DEXA scan video, you'll see that the thing I decided to do was to do 1800 calories on the days that I don't exercise and 2300 calories on the days that I do. And that's been working pretty well for me, at least for the last few weeks. So I'm going to go back to that for this week, planning on making sure that I have some treats for Halloween so that I don't feel tempted. I have a couple more bags of Smart Sweets that I'll probably eat on Halloween, and a keto cake that I've got saved for the occasion. I want to make sure that I'm prepared for safe things when I'm tempted with, you know, when holidays come around, you get tempted with the things you're used to having, right? The things that were part of the tradition of the day. So I always try and make sure that I have either some sugar-free chocolate or some treat that I normally don't have very often so that I feel like I'm participating in the tradition of the holiday, even though technically the food is not what makes the holiday great. Being with the family and dressing up and going and having fun is what makes the holiday great. But Halloween does center around candy, so I probably will make sure that I at least have a little bit of keto-friendly candy on hand so that I feel like I'm sharing in the holiday joy. So Measurements wise, last week my measurements were out of this world. I didn't even write them down. They were so much bigger. I think I put on at least 2 inches like everywhere. I can't remember what I said, but it was ridiculous, ridiculous, ridiculous. Today I'm back to normal on all my measurements except my hips. My hips are still an inch bigger than I had been. I don't know if that's still just water retention, bloating, or maybe I put on some fat and wasn't able to cut that this week. So regardless, I'm up an inch around my hips, but that's okay. I leave my number where it was and I just wait for my body to catch up. I don't go up and down on my measurements when I write them down. It's just way too much work. And I also did lose 1/4 inch off each of my arms, which I'm praying isn't muscle mass and is more either fat mass or skin mass, that movement there. But I don't know. You just never know with these things. So that's where I'm at measurements wise. If you're new to my channel, you may not realize I started out on this journey on January 1st, 2017 at 374 pounds. So I have come a long way since then. My lowest recorded weight was 174, about 0.2, I believe, recorded weight. But I actually did see 173 on the scale that same week. So that's the one that I go by in my head, even though it's not technically written down. So I have lost 200 pounds on this way of eating. And right now I am trying to manage maintenance and figure out what maintenance is going to look like for me. For me, maintenance is going to be a little bit similar and a little bit different than what I was doing when I was doing fat loss. So for fat loss, I was tracking every bite and making sure to keep at a certain protein level so that I maintain my lean mass and also keep my fats under control dietarily so that my body would burn body fat. Now for maintenance, I'm trying to keep that same protein level and raise fats up to a level where I will stop losing body fat, where I'm consuming enough dietary fat for that to happen. So for right now, I'm still trying to track everything very carefully so that I can get an idea of what is my safety zone so that hopefully in the future, I'll be able to do lazy keto and just eat what comes naturally to me, knowing what I normally need for maintenance. So I'm kind of tracked maintenance right now in the hopes that in the future, it'll just be my regular normal. And that's what I'll just do forever and ever. And I won't have to think about it as hard. At least that's my goal for right now. I'm trying to share my whole journey with you guys so that you understand what I did to get to maintenance. And maybe you can have a similar path. Obviously, maintenance is going to look different for every single person. Whatever is going to be your new normal and your new comfort zone is going to be different. I have people writing to me that say they really couldn't do that many calories and they would still gain weight. Or I have people telling me that the calories is too restrictive and that I need to have more. I have so much people giving me input all the time, but honestly, the only thing I can do is just try what feels right for me and see how that goes. So that's why I do these 3-month experiments where I try to stay the same as much as possible. I do DEXA scans before and after, so I have a really good judge of whether or not it's gonna work. And of course, once I get it to where I feel like I have maintained, I will not be bothering with the DEXA scans anymore or the tracking anymore. I will hopefully be to a place where I can just live and be in maintenance mode for the rest of my life. That's my goal. So that's what I'm focusing on right now. If you're looking for tips on weight loss, I have so many. If you look in my playlists, I have a list where I show all the foods that I eat for weight loss. I have a getting started guide list where it talks about macros and it talks about electrolytes and it talks about all of those great things of how you can get started on your own keto journey. And of course, I have a Facebook group where I help people get started on their journey and manage their journey as they go, give them advice right on my Facebook page. I try to be very active on there. I get on there every single day. So if you're looking for that kind of help and mentoring from me and my awesome moderator team, don't forget to check out the links in the About section below. If you would like to support this channel in any way, I have several ways you can do it. First way is the Teespring store, where I have super cute t-shirts and mugs that you can purchase, a one-time donation towards the channel. Also, I have a Patreon, which is where you can donate monthly. And those people who are Patreons of my channel are like a second family, and they get to see some of my special videos 24 hours before everyone else in like a preview showing as a thank you. So if you're interested in donating to the channel, even if it's just a dollar a month, you're always welcome to join the Patreon family. And of course, the link is in the About section below. If you'd like to just make a one-time donation, I am always grateful to accept PayPal. My PayPal email is in the About section. You can always write me emails asking questions and to get my macros chart. I do share the Getting Started guide that I have available on Facebook via email for free. So if you do not have Facebook and you're not looking for that help with the group and you just want the basics on getting started for this keto way of eating, just send me an email and I will send it to you right away. I'm pretty fast about sending it. I have it on my phone and I just respond and send it right away. So hopefully you'll get it quickly if you send me an email. I think that's everything. I just didn't want to forget anything for this video this week because I do feel kind of like I'm in a hurry because I'm super excited to go spend the afternoon and evening with my family and having a general fun Halloween time. So I gotta get going. So thanks so much for hanging out with me, you guys. I love y'all so much and I'll talk to you again soon.